Hi everyone, my name is Carolyn Lechman. I'm the new president of the Treblemakers. On behalf of the members of the chorus, I'd like to welcome you to our winter concert, A World of Hope for the Holidays. We've been working on these songs since September, the first week of September, and our hope is that our love of singing will convey to you the joy, the generosity, and the wonder of the holiday spirit, however you define it. If we accomplish that, we think the world will be a better place. I've been asked to tell you that today is the last day for the wreath raffle. There's a whole show of wreaths out there. And if you want one of those wreaths, please bid today. They will be selected tomorrow. And so, without further delay, if you would please turn off your devices, get comfortable, and we'll get started. So please welcome our director, Richard Romiti, and the entire Treblemakers chorus.
Christmas time is here, from a Charlie Brown's Christmas, with music by Vince Guaraldi and words by Lee Mendelson, is a poignant, timeless melody reminding us all of the love and hope we share, especially at this time of year.
Yeah. for us and all Israel, and let us say amen.
This is usually chanted during the part of the service called the Amidah, where the worshipers pray with their feet planted firmly together. Basically, you're trying to rid your mind of material and wandering thoughts, allowing more focus and clarity to your thoughts, sort of like yoga, meditation, and then it's all sealed with Hosei Shalom.
Hi there, my name is Sarah Freeman, and I wrote this song, Merrily the Bells Ring. I wrote this song because I like Christmas bells a lot, and I'm thrilled to be singing this with these wonderful singers, and I'm thrilled that Richard wrote an accompaniment, which he will be performing. And I would like to mention, if you're thinking of joining this chorus, you won't find a nicer bunch of people.
Thank you. 13 or 14 years ago, and at that time I knew that you needed to have a good melody, you needed to have some lyrics, and you needed to have a good beat or a good rhythm. But at that time I didn't realize there were three other main factors that you did need. Number one, I needed a good arranger, and I thank Richard for that. And I needed some good backup singers, and I thank Nancy, Carolyn, and Jackie for that. But third, and most important, you need to have a good audience. And I thank all of you for that one. At a time long ago, in a place far away, an angel of the Lord came to say, to a maiden so pure as the fresh fallen snow. And I wonder if really did she know?
Did she know?
Oh, did she know?
Did she know?
Oh, did she know? Mary, did you know
at the stall in Bethlehem,
when you took this little child and held him tight,
did you know that someday the whole world would say, let's give praise to the Lord for that night?
Did you know as you saw how your son began to grow, never knew just what the future held in store? Did you know when that boy
message and is sure to be an instant classic. You can say you heard it here first.
Christmas has come around again with thoughts of peace, goodwill toward men, but the Christmas spirit fade away. The hope of Christmas.
two settings of Ave Maria in classical repertoire. Very well-known version is by Franz Schubert. The version we're going to do this afternoon is actually, in modern parlance, it might actually be considered a mashup. What you're going to hear Richard play in the accompaniment is actually from J.S. Bach. It's a slightly modified version of his prelude number 1 in C major from Bach's Well-Tempered Clavier, written in the early 1700s. What I'm going to sing and add to it is the melody, which was actually written, it was improvised at first by the 19th century romantic French composer Charles Gounod, intended for this accompaniment with Bach. The Latin text, the Ave Maria or Hail Mary, was actually added some years later. So this afternoon, I'd like to present to you the Bach Gounod Ave Maria.
Tonight was arranged by our talented director, Richard Meady. They call this the Song of Angels. Many people believe angels look after us through a time of suffering or struggle, and this song was written right before the Civil War. The writer felt the message of peace must be portrayed. More than ever, our current world in turmoil needs a sense of stillness, peace, love, protection, and hope. We hope you can hear the angels sing while listening to it.
Oh, Makemaka to all of you, which means Merry Christmas in Hawaiian. The song was written by Robert Anderson, born in Honolulu, in 1894. As an American composer, he wrote over 100 island songs. The hibiscus which we are wearing is the Hawaiian state flower. If you wear it on your left, that means you're married and taken. And if you wear it on your right, that means you're available and free. Now this here, the Hawaiian lei is a sign of welcome. We three are sorry to say that we left our grass skirts and coconut bras at home.
Jr., Bette Midler, Diana Krall, Nancy Wilson, and Idina Menzel, and many more. The song exploded on YouTube in 2011 when Zooey Deschanel and Joseph Gordon-Levitt sang it as a duet and got over 17 million views. The version we're doing is by Ella Fitzgerald from 1960.
When the bells all ring and the horns all and the couples we know are fondly kissing, will I be with you, or will I be among the missing? Maybe it's much too early in the game, oh, but I
next number is Do You Hear What I Hear? And this is something that I never knew. The song was written by Noel Regney and Gloria Cheyne, who were married at the time. The song was written in 1962 and is a plea for peace during the Cuban Missile Crisis. Based loosely on the childhood classic, Rain, Rain, Go Away, Regney was inspired to write the lyrics after he watched innocent mothers pushing their babies in strollers around the park in New York City. Said the night wind to the little lamb, "Do you see what I see? Pray for peace, people everywhere." In 1962, I remember this very much. The threat of nuclear war was real during the Cuban Missile Crisis, so Regney and Cheyne could perform the entire song without becoming emotional, unlike me. And here we are, in 2017. Pray for peace, people everywhere.
It was set to a poem that was written by Placide Capot, I like my French pronunciation, in 1843 in honor of a recent renovation of a church organ in a small French town. The version later written in 1855 is the version that we know today, with the words added by Unitarian minister John Sullivan Dwight. Certainly a cavalcade of stars that made this a staple of holiday music. Everyone from your usual suspects, Bing Crosby, Perry Como, Andy Williams, and Celine Dion. And most notably, the very local, the late Father Jim Degnan at St. John the Evangelist Church just down the street made this a staple of the Christmas Vigil Mass. Here's O Holy Night.
Takes us on an international whirlwind through 5 languages, not even counting English. Whatever your language and whatever your creed, we Treblemakers wish you a world of hope, peace, and joy at the holidays and always.
Santa's home.
been invaluable. Patrick Fauché, we'd like to thank you for doing the background slideshow and the lights. He's an extraordinary musician on his own and knows just what buttons to push and when. We'd like to thank Jeff Doherty, one of our fabulous tenors, raise your hand, Jeff, for providing our poinsettia decorations. He and his wife, Dale, own Angel's Garden Shop in Upton. They have beautiful holiday arrangements and Christmas trees, so do stop by to see what they have. Jeff's wife, Dale, deserves her own thank you. Unfortunately, she's not here. She's tying bows and ribbons for all the arrangements you're going to buy. She designed the graphics for this year's concert, making us look very classy and professional. Tell Dale we said thank you. And of course, we'd like to thank you, our audience, for your continuing encouragement, patronage, and support. We wouldn't be here without you. Our spring concert is on Wednesday. Oh, I think we have a little presentation here. First, come on, don't be hesitant. This is for Richard, our director, and his wife. Front row, she makes us sweets every single week. We come and we get something special every week, which is very motivating for us to sing to rehearsal. So thank you so much.
Troublemakers would like very much like thank you and Nancy, aka Molly, for all y'all have done to keep us together and really structure us. It's a hard job.
January 10th, which is a Wednesday. If you can carry a tune and would like to be in a chorus, please take one of the flyers that are in the lobby. It has a few more details, and then you can call me or email me if you have any questions about what's involved. My number and email are on that flyer. So now, it's your turn. Steve Sullivan, one of our incredible basses, will lead us in the sing-along. So, you've got sheets. I hope they were passed out to you.
You have a sing-along sheet.
Raise your hand.
It doesn't have any mention of the Cuban Missile Crisis.
After the sing-along, please join the chorus in out front for some refreshments. They're in the lobby, and we'd love to talk to you. Thank you again for coming to the Troublemakers concert. Happy holidays to you and the whole wide world. Yay!
So if everybody has a sheet, what song would you like to sing? Anybody, raise your hand. We have a choice here. Yeah, here we go. Back in the back row. Which song?
Let It Snow.
Let It Snow. Okay. Let It Snow?